We will continue to apply maximum pressure on the Iranian regime to deny it the means to conduct its destructive foreign policy and compel the regime to negotiate a comprehensive new deal that addresses the full scope of its malign behavior. There is a path forward, and we will talk tomorrow if they would like to see the bright future that we believe is there for the Iranian people.
There is the State Department, there, Trump administration trying to dial back the tension with Iran, saying the U.S. does not want war. John Bolton accusing Tehran of carrying out the attacks on Saudi ships recently in the Persian Gulf. Senator Rand Paul, Foreign Relations, Homeland Security Committee, is with us in studio, and nice to see you again. First on Iran, I want to double back on a lot of things that we were just talking about. What's going on here?
You know, I think the president's been able to strike a real balance, letting Iran and other countries know that we won't be trifled with, but at the same time saying that we're open to diplomacy. There are talks of other countries actually beginning diplomatic talks with Iran, and the president hasn't said he won't talk to Iran. I think that's a good thing. He's taken the decision to have diplomacy with North Korea. It doesn't mean there's an easy answer, either with Iran or North Korea, that we're going to get exactly what we want, but I think diplomacy is a good idea.
He expressed that when he was in Tokyo.
I think that the president strikes a real balance. When I talk to him, I get this idea that war is a terrible, destructive thing. We go to war when we have to. I think it's also important for the American people to know that presidents don't get to make this decision. Congress has to vote on whether we go to war.
You know, there's a lot of talk now after the statement from Bob Mueller yesterday. Quickly on that, Justin Amash, the Republican from Michigan, he's calling for impeachment. Here was the tweet that went out just seconds after Bob Mueller started talking. The ball is in our court, Congress. What do you think of that?
You know, as a libertarian Republican, I think the whole investigation sort of has an unlibertarian feel. You have intelligence community that has so much power that many libertarians, we've always said, gosh, this much power could be abused. And when I look at it, I see an abuse of power from Comey, from Clapper, from Brennan, from all of these guys who I think took this power that they had, this great power we entrusted with them to spy on foreigners, and they directed it against Americans for partisan reasons. So I think this has to be investigated, and I think it's wrong for any Republican to think, oh, gosh, this is a legitimate investigation. I think it's a very partisan investigation.
You have been one of the leading voices against the FISA courts.
Absolutely.
Suggesting that it needs to be reformed. I do believe Bill Barr is looking at the same thing here. You spoke to the president last night. What did you express to him?
Well, the president tells me, both publicly and privately, that basically he doesn't want this to happen to other people, whether it's a Democrat president or political activists, you know, Republicans, Democrats. He doesn't want our intelligence community to be used for partisan reasons. He thinks it happened to him, but he also wants to make sure moving forward that it doesn't. What I've been promoting to the president is basically the idea that this is intelligence information that's gathered with a lower standard than the Constitution, that they shouldn't look at this database for an American's information unless you have a warrant. So for General Flynn, they should have gone to a court and asked for a warrant. We want to listen to General Flynn's conversation. They didn't do that. To protect us, I think there's a way the president could change the rules for the FBI.
How do you codify that? How do you put that into law?
I think the president has the ability to do it by executive order. He could say to the FBI that from now on our policy is that the FBI has to go to get a court order or a warrant in a public court to search this database for an American's information. Now, it's different for foreigners. We spy on foreigners all the time, and there's a lower standard. But for an American, it's extraordinary that our own intelligence community that's supposed to spy on foreigners was spying on the Trump campaign. So this shouldn't happen either to President Trump, but to any future president of either
party. Last question. I don't know if you have another feeling on Amash or whether or not this is going to gain some sort of groundswell among Republicans. I don't know what Nancy Pelosi does, but your feeling on that.
I think the investigation was wrong. It was an abuse of power. I don't think that if there's an impeachment, it's going to be a partisan thing. I don't see any other Republicans joining the call for impeachment.
Senator, thank you for your time. Rand Paul, the Republican from Kentucky.
Thank you.